How can we be possibly satisfied that this bill would deliver equality and freedom in death when we do not yet have this in life? I wanted to start by commending the comments from the Honourable Member for Ronnie Bridge and Weybridge, because I think he outlined some of the complications with this legislation as it stands. I also wanted to put on record my admiration for the Right Honourable Member for Birmingham Labourwood, who in my opinion has been disgracefully singled out for her support of this bill in comparison to others. The bill before us today is potentially the most consequential piece of legislation that's been considered during my time in this House, and it's at the heart of the matter of why I came into politics. A lot of us have spoken about coercion, and it's about providing a voice for the people who don't often have one of their own. It is this principle that has guided my decision to oppose this bill today. I know that there are sincerely held beliefs on both sides of this debate, and they can seem completely at odds with each other. But it is my firm view that everyone speaking today shares the same goal, a more compassionate society in which everyone can live and die with dignity. But, Madam Deputy Speaker, true compassion should have equality at its heart. It is for this reason I cannot support the proposals as it stands. We must recognise the hard truth that health inequalities are wide and persistent. We know that black and minority ethnic disabled people have far worse health outcomes than the national average.
Yeah.
I've seen this firsthand. Caring for my mother, who suffered with sickle cell anemia. As a teenager, I would be by her side when she was in excruciating pain, explaining to a doctor who would not believe her when she told them she needed life-saving medication. And sadly, this is still the reality today.
Yeah.
I am reminded of the death of Evan Smith on the 25th of April at North Middlesex Hospital. Evan suffered from sickle cell too. He was in so much pain that he had to ring 999 from his hospital bed because he was denied oxygen and basic care by the doctors. Put simply, Madam Deputy Speaker, we should be helping people to live comfortable, pain-free lives on their own terms before we think about making it easier for them to die.
Exactly.
Colleagues will be aware of Section 15 of the proposed bill, which outlines the provision for sign-in by proxy. I'm worried that this could create an issue for vulnerable groups who are more prone to coercion by family members. And as many members have already said, assessing beyond doubt if someone has been put under pressure or coerced will be difficult if this legislation is passed. Even the legal experts seem to have a disagreement on this, so I do not believe there has been enough scrutiny on this.
True.
And the risk of coercion will be for the highest of some of the most disadvantaged people in our communities.
Yeah.
As a society, we risk pushing people to seek an early death. I cannot in good conscience support this.
Yeah.
My late mother lived with chronic illness all her life. And I knew that one day her pain would be too unbearable for her. But she did not let that limit her. She wanted to live. And I believe this bill would protect the wishes. This bill would not protect the wishes of her, people in her situation today. Because freedom in death is only possible if you have had freedom in life. And I will close by asking this, Madam Deputy Speaker. How can we be possibly satisfied that this bill would deliver equality and freedom in death when we do not yet have this in life?
Yeah.